स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। स्क्रीन दिसते का?
हो मैम।
सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव टू सी अ डिफरेंट मेथड ऑफ प्रोपेगेशन, ओके, सेक्सुअल एंड असेक्सुअल प्रोपेगेशन। देन आई हैव आल्सो सीन एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ प्रोपेगेशन मेथड। सो दिस इज द रेसिस्टिव मेथड ऑफ प्रोपेगेशन। In vegetative method of propagation, there are different methods like types of grafting, types of cutting, then budding, layering, etc. Okay, so the first type is cutting. On the basis of the plant part use and relative position on a plant, cuttings are classified into various. So the first is the stem cutting. Stem cutting. A stem cutting is any cutting taken from the main shoot of the plant or any side shoots growing from the same plant. Any cutting taken from the shoot plants. Okay. Or any shoots growing from the same plants. Cutting that. It is the branch of the plants that can be used for the propagation of producing new plants. Okay, so the cuttings are different, like some hardwood cutting, softwood cutting, semi-hardwood cutting, and herbaceous cutting. So these cuttings are classified according to the age of the cuttings. The shoots with high carbohydrate content, usually root is better. Those shoots, the shoots having high carbohydrate content. This cutting produces better root. Okay. Broadly, there are four types of stem cutting, namely hardwood cutting, semi-hardwood cutting, and herbaceous cutting. This is the different methods of cuttings. First is the hardwood cutting. That means the mature branch or the mature parts of the cuttings. Of the plant. This is the hardwood cutting. This is this cutting is age is the 1 year old. Okay, this is called as hardwood cutting. 1 year old are used for the propagation. This is called as hardwood cutting. Semi hardwood cutting. That means the age of the cutting is 6 to 9 months. Okay, this is the semi hardwood cutting. And softwood cutting. That means the age of the cutting is 3 months up to 3 months. Okay. This is the node and this is the petiole. So the first is the hardwood cutting. Cutting from a mature and lignite stem of shrubs and trees are called as hardwood cutting. Hardwood cuttings are prepared during a dormant season and usually from old shoots of previous season growth. Okay. So hardwood cutting means 1 year old shoots of a fresh season growth. And the size of cutting varies from 10 to 45 centimeter in length and 0.5 to 2.5 centimeter in diameter, depending upon the species. Okay, this is the length and length or the size of the cuttings. For the planting of cuttings, the height of or the length of cutting, it should be 10 to 45 centimeter in length and 0.5 to 2.5 centimeter in diameter. Okay, usually cutting is 25 to 30 centimeter length are used and it is a pencil thickness. Size is pencil thickness. Okay, this is the standard size of cuttings for hardwood. Each cutting should have at least 3 or more buds. While preparing the cuttings, a straight cut is given on the base of shoot below the node, while slanting cut 1 to 2 cm above and bud is given at the top of cutting. Okay, so the how to cut the cutting for the propagation. First, the upper side of cutting give slanting cut. Okay, top portion slanting cut and lower portion is give the straight cut. Okay. However, in case of hollow pit spaces such as kiwi fruit, top cut should also be close to the bud to avoid drying up of the top portion. And in some cases like kiwi fruit, top cut should be given close to the bud to avoid the drying of top portion. In each cuttings having 2 to 3, it's required 2 to 3 nodes per cutting, at least 3 or more buds. For a typical and for tropical and subtropical crops, straight cut is given at the top in order to minimize the transpiration loss, and slant cut should be given at the base to expose more area for the absorption of water and nutrients. Okay, this is the reason of tropical and subtropical crops. For the top portion, give slanting cut. Straight cut. Okay, top portion of cutting use the straight cut to minimize the transpiration loss, and slanting cut given to lower portion. That means the part of the plants buried in the soil that use the slanting cut to expose more area for the absorption of water and nutrient. This helps in maintaining the polarity of the shoots, and in if rain occurs, the water does not accumulate on the tip of the cuttings, which saves the cutting from fungal infection. Okay, if you give the slanting cut on the top portion of the cutting, that means if the rain occurs, the water cannot accumulate on the tip of cutting, and which saves the cutting from fungal infection. A number of deciduous fruit like grape, kiwi fruit, then hazelnut, chestnut, fig, quince, pomegranate, mulberry, plum, olive, and gooseberry, etc. are commercially propagated by hardwood cutting. Okay, this is the fruit. This is the fruit crop mainly propagated through hardwood cutting. Then semi-hardwood cutting. It is also called as greenwood cutting. Semi-hardwood cutting are those made from woody, broad-leaved evergreen species with partially mature wood. Okay, partially mature wood are used for the propagation is called as semi-hardwood cutting. These type of cutting are mostly used in evergreen fruits like fruit plants like mango, guava, lemon, jackfruit, some shrubs and shrubby ornamental plants. The length of cutting varies from 7 to 20 centimeter. Cuttings are prepared by trimming the cutting with straight cut below the node and remove a few lower leaves. Okay, straight cut given below the nodes and remove some leaves on the lower portion. However, it is better to retain 2 to 4 leaves on the top of the cuttings and take 2 to 4 leaves on the top portion of the cutting, while 1/4 cutting should be inserted into soil. 1/4 portion of cutting should be inserted into the soil. The best time of taking such a cutting in summer when new shoots have emerged and their wood is partially mature. This is the time of taking cuttings. In summer season, when the shoot emerges new leaves, new shoots, and it is partially mature. It is necessary that leafy cuttings should be rooted under condition when water loss from leaves is minimum. If you take few leaves on the cuttings. That means the water loss through the leaves will be minimum. Commercially, such cuttings are rooted under intermittent mist, fog, and under the polythene sheets. For the carried out propagation operation, it should be in the nursery because the temp climate required for the cuttings, preparing new cuttings, it is a like means it's require humid climate, then minimum temperature, and covering minimum temperature, that is a cover the place with the polythene sheets, etc. Then softwood cutting. Cuttings prepared from the soft, succulent, and non-lignified shoots, which are not hard or woody, are called as softwood cutting. Okay, this is the very less age of the cutting. That means the that cuttings are not so hard and woody. Succulent, soft succulent cuttings are used for the softwood cutting. Okay. Such type of cuttings are very prone to desiccation. Very prone to desiccation. Okay, so the success percentage of softwood cutting is very less because the desiccation may be desiccation is very more in this type of cutting. Therefore, the proper arrangement of controlling humidity is required. Okay, the size of cutting is 5 to 5.7 centimeter, but it may vary from species to species. Okay, according to the species, the cutting length of or the size of cutting, it may be varied. In general, some leaves should be retained with this type of cutting. It's required, this type of cutting is also required, some leaves on the cutting. The best time for preparing softwood cutting is late summer. Generally, root easier and quick than over other types, but require more attention and sophisticated equipment for this type of cutting. Similarly, the temperature should be maintained 23 to 27 degrees Celsius during rooting at the base of cutting. Temperature is 23 to 27 degrees Celsius during rooting. Then fourth one is the herbaceous cutting. Herbaceous cutting are made from succulent non-woody plants like geranium, chrysanthemum, coleus, carnation, and many foliage crop. This type of cutting is very succulent or the non-woody area. Okay, that means this type of cutting is having no wood. Okay, example geranium, chrysanthemum, coleus, and carnation. This type of cutting mostly used for ornamental crops or the flower crops. These are usually 7 to 15 centimeter long with a few leaves retained at the upper end. These are rooted under the same condition at as that of the softwood cutting, requiring high relative humidity. Herbaceous bottom heat is also useful for initiation of rooting process, and herbaceous cutting of some plants include a sticky sap as in geranium, pineapple, and cactus that interferes with the root initiation process. In such cases, basal ends of cutting should be allowed to dry for a few hours before planting. And generally, fruit plants are not propagated by herbaceous cutting. Mainly, flower crops and ornamental crops can be propagated by this cutting. Then, next part is the root cutting. First, we have to see stem cutting, and this is the root cutting. Propagation by means of root is also simple and cheap method of vegetative propagation in the spaces which are difficult to propagate by other methods. In general, the plants which are produced suckers freely are easily propagated by root cutting. Okay, plants produces and that plants can be easily propagated by root cuttings. For a root cutting, roots are of 1 centimeter thickness and 10 to 15 centimeter in long are cut into. Okay, the thickness is 1 centimeter and length is 10 to 15 centimeter. Best time for taking the root cutting is late winter and early spring when roots are well supplied with store food material. Okay, so for the root cutting, the root should be mature for the supply and store the food material. However, in temperate fruit, root cuttings are prepared in the month of December and kept in a warm place. In wash grass and wet sand for callusing and are the transplanted in the nursery during February, March in the open beds. Time of planting, time of root cutting is month of December. Okay, and this type of cuttings are mainly used for the temperate fruits. That means the plants are growing in a cool place. They are kept in a warm place in a moss grass and bed sand for callusing. Okay, callusing, that means the proper growth of the plants. And then they are transplanted in the nursery during February to March in the open beds. Blackberry, raspberry are commercially propagated by this method. However, kiwi fruit, then breadfruit, fig, rose, mulberry, apple, pear, peach, cherry are propagated by root cutting. Most of the temperate fruit crops can be propagated by root cutting. Then a leaf cutting. Propagation through leaf bud cuttings is a partially useful in some in spaces where leaf develop a root system but die because of non-development of shoot system. Sometimes on the portion of the leaf, roots are grow if they are placed in the soil. Leaf buds are commercially particularly useful when planting material is scarce because each nodes in the leaf can be used as a cutting. Leaf bud cutting should preferably are prepared during growing season because the birds if enter into the dormancy may be difficult to force to active stage, hereby inhibit the rooting in a such cutting. Sometimes leaf bud going to the dormancy period and it is very difficult to active and they can inhibit the root in the cutting. Leaf bud cutting. A leaf bud cutting consists of leaf blade, petal and short piece of the stem with attached ovary bud of actively growing leaves. But leaf bud are also used for the propagating. Leaf bud cutting to 10 to 15 centimeter in length portion is used when propagating material is small. This type of methods are mostly used in a blackberry, raspberry, lemon, and camellia. Next one method of vegetative propagation is layering. Layering technique is a form of rooting of cutting in which adventitious roots are initiated on the stem while it is still attached to the mother plant. Okay, layering, that means rooting of cutting in which adventitious roots are initiated on the stem while it is still attached to the mother plant. The root stem layer, rooted stem, is detached, transplanted, while later becomes a separate plant on its own roots. Okay, after the rooting of a branch, they can be detached from mother plant and transplanted into the new area on its own root. It is a natural means of propagation in a black raspberry and trailing blackberries, or it may be induced artificially in many plants like clonal rootstock of apple. In general, better rooting in the layer can be contained by ringing or wounding, etiolation, or by using hormones like IBA, NA, and providing favorable environmental condition, temperature, and humidity. For the rooting of cuttings, early rooting of cuttings, we have to give a treatment for the cuttings with IBA and NAA, providing favorable environment and condition. Then it should be give roots in early age of cuttings. Advantages of layering. It is an effective method of propagating species that is usually do not root easily by cutting, as mango, lychee, filberts, and camphor. This is rooting of plant is not easy by cutting. Okay, so that's we have we use layering. It is a natural method of propagation in blackberries and raspberries. It does not require precise control of water, relative humidity, temperature, as for other method of propagation. Okay. Easy to perform and does not require much infrastructure. This is the layering advantages of layering. Then some disadvantages. Costly in areas where labor availability is a problem. Limited number of plants can be produced. Plants produced through layering have usually small brittle roots. Okay. And mortality rate is particularly higher in air layered plants. Mortality, that means the dying of the plants after layering operation. It is high. This is a type of layering. There are different types of layering, including simple layering, compound serpentine layering, continuous trench layering, air layering, mound or stool layering. Of these, the most commercially important are mound layering for multiplication of rootstock and air layering for some tropical crops. Okay, simple layering, compound or serpentine layering, continuous trench layering, air layering, and mound layering. This is the five types of layering. First one is the simple layering. Simple layering consists of bending in intact shoot to the ground to cause adventitious root. Okay. Simple layering, that means the, in this picture we, you can see, sorry, simple layering, that means the branch are bent into intact shoot to the ground. Okay, and that can be produce a adventitious root. This method can be used to propagate a wide range of plants, indoor and outdoor, on woody shrubs that produce numerous suckers. Simply, branches are bent within a soil that can produce adventitious root After producing adventitious roots, the rooted plants can be cut from some cut and then planted to another place. This is called as simple layering. Layering is usually done in the early spring using flexible dormant 1 year old shoot branch of the plant, and that can be bent easily to the ground. Okay, then shoots are bent and pegged down at the location 15 to 20 centimeter from the tip, forming a U shape. Okay, 15 to 20 centimeter portion of portion of the branch that can be bent in the soil. That means it gives a forming a U shape. Bending, twisting, cutting and girdling at the bottom of U stimulates rooting at that location. The portion of U shape portion are buried in the soil that can produce a rooting. The base of the layer is covered with soil and other media, leaving the tip exposed, and the tip portion of the branch is exposed to the sun. This is the simple layering, and next one is the compound or serpentine layering. In this simple layering, only a one portion, that is the U portion, okay, only this portion can be bent, that is U portion are bent in the soil and then tip portion are exposed to the sun. This is a simple layering, only one U shape. Okay, this is a simple layering. And compound layering, compound or serpentine layering, that is the alternate bending of a branch. It is the modification of simple layering in which 1 year old branch is alternatively covered and exposed along its length. Okay, the branch is alternatively covered with soil. The stem is girdled at different points in the underground part. However, it is exposed portion, the exposed portion of the stem should have at least one bud to develop a new shoots. Okay, the exposed portion of the stem should have at least one bud to develop new shoots. After rooting, the sections are cut and lean out in the field. In this way, many new plants can be made from one branch. It is also an easy plant propagation method, but is suitable only for plants producing slender, long and flexible shoots. Muscadine grapes is commercially propagated by this method. This is the compound and serpentine layering. That means the this is the alternative covering of a branch with soil and exposing to the sun. Tip portion exposed to the sun, and it should have one bud to producing a new shoot. Okay. And this is the buried portion of the soil. If this plant is this leaves are grow, that means the rooting is occur, and if the leaves are die, that means this portion having a no root. Okay, and at the time of planting into the new place, the portion is cut from this place both sides, and then these plants are planted into the new place. Okay, then next one method is the continuous and or the trench layering. In this picture you can see this is the trench layering. Okay, underground trenching of the plant, that means a rooting of underground plant. In this method, it is the most common method of propagation for woody plants which produce long vines and are difficult to propagate by other method of propagation. Vigorous rootstock like apple M14 and M25 and walnut can easily be propagated by trench layering. In this method, important to establish a permanent row of plants to be propagated. Plants are planted at the base of the trench at an angle of 450 in a row space and 90 centimeters apart. The long and flexible stem of these plants are pegged down on the ground to form a continuous line of layered plants. Okay, that means the branches are fully pegged down with the on the ground, a continuous line of layered plants. Then the young shoots that arise from the plants are gradually mounded up to the depth of 15 to 20 centimeter. In autumn, winter or the end of the growing season, depending on the species to be propagated. The young shoots arise from this plant. Okay, the shoots arise from this plant. They gradually mounding up to the depth of 15 to 20 centimeter in autumn season and winter season or the end of the growing season, depending on the species of process to be propagated. Okay, mounding up, that means the covering of the plants with soil. Okay, this is the trenching method. And next one is the air layering. It is also called as marcottage, gutticulum, pot layerage. Okay, this is the commercial method of propagation, mainly used in the guava, then pomegranate. Okay, air layering is the ancient method of layering, originally introduced from China and now commercially used for the propagation of number of tropical and subtropical and shrubs, including lychee, guava, mango, longan, Persian lime, ficus, and croton. Layers are made in the spring or summer on the stem of the previous season growth. Then the presence of active leaves on the layer should be speed root formation. Layers are prepared by making upward cut of about 5 cm long and at or about center of the shoots. Layers are prepared by making upward cut. Okay, this is the layering method of air layering. In this portion we can see this is the layering portion and the bark of the plant branch removed from this portion and the opening of cambium tissue. Okay, and this portion can be covered with the sphagnum moss. This is the sphagnum moss that can be covered with this portion. And then after covering with sphagnum moss, the sphagnum moss cover with the transparent polythene. Okay, and tied with the thread. Okay. Layers are prepared by making upward cut about 5 cm at or about center of the shoots. Okay, the shoots are then girdled by removing the ring of bark about 2 cm wide. Okay, remove the ring of bark about 2 cm wide. And the upper part of the wood is applied with the IBF paste made in lanolin. This is the bark remove portion, and this part treat with IBA for and also you can also treat sphagnum moss can be treated with the IBA that can also produce a root from branch. The wound is covered with the moist sphagnum moss in a way to provide a complete cover to it. Polythene film is a wrap around the moss grass in such a way that as to leave no opening which could allow evaporation of moisture from the moss. Okay, The rooted layers may be served from mother plant and may be planted in the nursery under shade. After 1 month or 1.5 month, the polythene cover area producing a white root, and that means the layering process is successful, and then rooted portion can be cut from the mother plant and transplanted in the new place or in the nursery. This is called as air layering. Okay, this is a very commercial method, and now mainly used for the propagation of air layering, propagation of pomegranate, lychee and guava is quickest method of propagation. Then mound stool layering or stooling. The term stooling was first coined by Lynch in 1942 for mound layering. It is the method of propagation in which shoot plants are cut back to the ground and soil or rooting medium is mounded around a new sprout shoots to stimulate roots to develop their base. Okay. The shoots are covered with the soil, the specific distance, and the covered portion producing a root. This method is commercially used to propagate apple, pear, quince, currants, gooseberry, and other fruit crops. In stooling, mother plant is headed back to 15 to 20 centimeter above ground level during dormant season. This is the mound layering. Okay, the shoot portion covered with the soil. This is the shoot portion covered with the soil, and then after covering of the covering with the soil, the covered portion produces a root. Okay, this portion can be produce a root, and then the rooted portion can be cut from this place and grow into the or planted into the another place. The new sprout will arise within 2 months. Okay, new sprouts arise in 2 months. The sprouts are then girdled near the base, and a rooting hormone IBA made in a lanolin paste is applied to the upper portion of the ring. Okay, the concentration of IBA depends on the species to species, but generally 3000 to 5000 ppm is commonly used. After the girdle portion and the rooting hormone made lanolin place and applied to the upper portion of ring. Care should be taken to the to keep the soil heap moist all the time. It facilitates rooting the stools. Okay, the mounding portion should be take moist for the early initiation of root. The roots in the shoots may emerge within 30 to 40 days. However, the rooted shoot should be severed from the mother plants only after 60 to 70 days and then planted in the nursery field. Okay, after rooting, the plants are planted after 60 to 70 days. The new place. Then tip layering. It is the simplest from layering, which often occurs naturally. The tips of shoots are buried 5 to 10 centimeter deep in the soil. Rooting is buried. Shoots take place within a month. The new plants layer may be detached and transplanted in the soil during spring. In this method, this is the natural method of propagation for blackberries, raspberries, however, currants, gooseberries, and rambling roses can also be propagated by tip layering easily. Okay, tip layering, that means the tip portion of the plants can be buried in the soil with 5 to 10 centimeter deep. Okay, and that portion can be produced root after 1 month. And after rooting of this portion, the portion detached from the mother plants and transfer into the new place during the spring season. Okay, this is the tip layering. This is the tip, and this deep are buried with the soil, producing a root at this place, and then the rooted portion are cut from this mother plant and then planted into the new place. Okay, so this is all about rooting of cutting, stem cutting, then layering. This is the two method of propagation, cuttings and layering. In cutting, first is the stem cutting. In stem cutting, there are again classified into four categories. First one is the hardwood cutting, soft semi hardwood cutting, softwood cutting, and herbaceous cutting. Okay. Then next method is the root cutting. Okay. And next one is the leaf cutting. This is the methods of cutting. And this is the layering. Next one method of propagation is the layering. Then layering is also classified into different categories. First one is the simple layering. Then continuous or serpentine, compound or serpentine layering. Third number is the continuous trench layering. Fourth one is the mound air layering. Fifth one, mound layering. And sixth one is the tip layering. Okay, so this is all about cuttings and layering.